Hello and welcome to a new video on the Cryptography for Everybody channel. In today's video, we will have a look at the Spanish Strip Cipher. The Spanish Strip Cipher was a hand cipher that was used during the Spanish Civil War. And we will have a look at how this cipher works and how we can break it. As usual, I structured the video into different parts. In the first part, we will have a look at a brief history of the Spanish Strip Cipher. Then we will have a look in detail at the Spanish Strip Cipher itself and how it works. After that, in the cryptanalysis part of the Spanish Strip Cipher, we will mainly have a look at the keyspace size of the Spanish Strip Cipher. And finally, we want to do it in CrypTool too. That means we will encrypt using the Spanish Strip Cipher, then of course decrypt. And finally, we want to decipher a ciphertext that was encrypted with the Spanish Strip Cipher, but not using the cipher itself. We will use the Homophonic Substitution Analyzer implemented in CrypTool too. The Spanish Strip Cipher, or abbreviated SSC, was the most used encryption algorithm during the Spanish Civil War, and the Spanish Civil War was from 1936 to 1939. And the information I present here I took mainly from this nice paper here. So when you are interested in more details about the Spanish Strip Cipher and the cryptanalysis of the Spanish Strip Cipher, I highly recommend that you have a look at this paper. Both sides of the Spanish Civil War, the Nationalists and the Republicans, both used cryptography, of course, to protect their communication. In parallel to the usage of cryptography, they also did some cryptanalysis, and both sides had a so-called eavesdropping and decrypting unit. Also, both sides used different hand ciphers, for instance, the monoalphabetic substitution cipher, we already had a video about this on this channel, then, of course, homophonic substitution ciphers, and the Spanish Strip Cipher is such a homophonic substitution cipher, then Playfair ciphers, and a variation of the Gronsfeld cipher. I did not yet have a video about this, maybe I will create a video about the Gronsfeld cipher in the future. Then, additionally to using hand ciphers, they used encryption machines. They used the Enigma, they used the Kriha machine, and they used Hagelin machines. On the right side here, you can see a picture that I took from Wikipedia, which shows some example pictures from the Spanish Civil War. Now let's speak about the Spanish Strip Cipher in detail. As I already said, the Spanish Strip Cipher is a homophonic substitution cipher. We already had videos about homophonic substitution ciphers. For instance, the Zodiac Killer also used a homophonic substitution cipher. And the Spanish Strip Cipher consists of an ordered alphabet, a random alphabet, and a homophone table. What this all means, I will now describe. It uses a keyword and an initial position to create the random alphabet. So what do we have here? We have the initial position here, for instance, C equals B. Then on top of a paper, for instance, we have this ordered alphabet here. Below that, we have our random alphabet, and then we have our homophone table. So how do these terms all belong together? The random alphabet at first is created as follows. First, you select a random key. In our example, for instance, the word CrypTool. Then we create a table, and the first row starts with the keyword, and we use each letter only once. You can see such a table here. We fill the keyword into the table. Here we have CrypTool, but of course we only use the O once. And then we put the remaining alphabet letters here below this keyword. And after that, we read out the random alphabet column-wise. So the first part of our alphabet is C-A-Y-S. This is the first column. The second column is R-B-J-U, and so on, and so on, and so on, until we have read out the complete alphabet. And the number of columns here is defined by the length of our keyword. This is how we generate the random alphabet. Now let's create the final Spanish strip cipher using the before created random alphabet and the initial position. And here we see where we need the initial position. we shift the random alphabet until the initial position is reached. That means C equals B when our initial position is C equals B. And that means that B is below C. You can see this below here. We have our random alphabet here, but the random alphabet started with a C here. But in this case, we have now the S here, because we shifted the alphabet to the right until the B in the random alphabet is below the C here. And then this is the remaining alphabet. We have the C, A, I, S, and we have here C, A, I, S, R. Clearly, we have to shift these back into the random alphabet here. And this here is our final cipher that we then use. So now let's have a look at how to encrypt using this table here. Now let's encrypt, for example, hello world. We have our plain text here, and we now use the strip cipher here. So first we have to encrypt the H, and for that we look into the random alphabet where the H is, then we have this column here, and we use one of the homophones, for instance 34, and encrypt H with 34. Then with the E we do the same, we go to the E column in the random alphabet, and we take for instance the 17. And now an interesting part comes, because we have two times an L. We go to the L column, take the first homophone for instance 29, and then the second homophone 50. And we go on and on and on and encrypt our plain text to this number text here. And how can we decrypt that? That's as easy as the encryption. We have here our 34. We have to search for 34 here in the numbers. And then we go up to the random alphabet and write H, for instance. And we do the same for the E. We have 17, go here to the 17 in the column here, go up the E, write the E. 29 we have here, go to the L, 50, go to the 50 here, L, and so on. So encryption and decryption is really easy with this table here. Now let's have a look at the key space size. So how many possible keys do we have? And I have two different key space sizes here. And these key space sizes are based on some assumptions. The first assumption I have here with the first size is I have a fixed table of homophones. So we can think of that you got the ordered alphabet here, then you got all the homophones already here, but the random alphabet is empty. In this case, we also assume that this table is known to an attacker. So only the random alphabet is unknown. And this is like the simple monoalphabetic substitution cipher that we already know. And we know that we have to compute the key space size using the factorial of the number of letters. In this case, the random alphabet is a permutation of the ordered alphabet. And therefore, the key space size is 27 factorial. 27 because we have this special letter here in the Spanish alphabet. And the factorial of 27 is about 2 to the power of 93. Now let's assume that also we have an unknown table of homophones. So we didn't get the numbers. We have also to find out the numbers. In that case, the key space size is about 2 to the power of 412. And I took this number here from this paper. I think in the paper is a small mistake, because they also multiplied this number with this number, because you can exchange the random alphabet. But I think for cryptanalysis, the random alphabet is irrelevant if you have also to find out the homophones. You can think of that by yourself and tell me what you think. Do we have to multiply these two numbers, or do we have to take this number when we have an unknown table of homophones? Now comes the practical part of this video, and we want to do it in CrypTool 2. I have two tasks. The first task is that I want to encrypt and decrypt using the Spanish Strip Cipher component in CrypTool 2. And after that, I want to decipher a ciphertext using the Homophonic Substitution Analyzer in CT2, and clearly the ciphertext has been encrypted using the Spanish Strip Cipher. So let's go to CrypTool 2. I'm here now in CrypTool 2 in the Start Center, And at first, I want to show you where you can find the Spanish Strip Cipher. And as with all the videos I made on this channel, you find some templates or a template. And here we search for Spanish. And then we have Spanish Strip Cipher. And we just open this template. And here we have it. We have a text input, which takes a plain text. We have the Spanish Strip Cipher component, and we have a text output and some explanation. And I think that I also want to copy this text because we will use this text to break it using the Homophonic Substitution Analyzer later on. So you enter your plain text here. Then you can choose the keyword as we have done in the previous slides. And in this case, I want to have a keyword, let's say keyword. And every time I type here, you see that the homophone table that you can see here, the assignment of letters to homophones changes. And I want to change the position of the random alphabet. Let's do E and R. And the homophone selection is random. That means that when an F is encrypted, it randomly chooses one of these homophones. When we change this to round robin, then it will first take, when it sees an F, the 10, then the 37, then the 61, then the 81, and then start again with the 10. But I want to have it random. Now we have also the Spanish alphabet here. I think I want to have, yeah, the Spanish alphabet is fine. And we can choose 90 homophones, 99 homophones, or we can choose a random homophones table, but I stick to 90 homophones. Now let's encrypt the text and let's see what we get. We get a huge text here of 1486 digits that I copy right now with Control C. Then I stop this workspace here. I paste it over into my plain text here. This is now my ciphertext, so we can decrypt here. Just press play. And then we see here, I resize this, that we have a nice plain text. Of course, it seemed that it removed all the non-Latin letters that we had in this text. Now let's try if we can break this using the Homophonic Substitution Analyzer in CrypTool 2. So I copy the ciphertext again, then I go to the Start Center, and I search for the Homophonic Substitution Analysis and open it. Here we already see a similar looking text that also consists only of digits, and I just paste my text into this text input here. Then this has to be set to block size of 2, so it cuts this text into blocks of 2 and puts spaces between these blocks so that the Homophonic Substitution Analyzer has a separated ciphertext here. Our dictionary is set to English. We had an English text. The Homophonic Substitution Analyzer is set also to English, but we don't use spaces. Now let's have a look if we can actually break it. Just press play. Then we get our numbers here and we get a representation of the ciphertext here. And when we click on Analyze, it already has, I just saw like Spanish. Sometimes it doesn't work, then we need to restart it. We have here Spanish. Strip. This is Cipher. To be honest, I didn't have a look at the text, so it's as if I decipher an unknown text. What is the Spanish strip? And this is cipher here, so this is a P. So when you right-click in the analyzer, you can change the letter to the next letter in the alphabet. And when you shift right-click, you can change the letter here to the previous letter in the alphabet. And with F11 and F12, I resize this that I have a full screen. And this here has to be H. And when I decipher text like this here with the Homophonic Substitution Analyzer, I use a trick because I want to see where else do I have the 88 here. And with the left mouse button, I can fix a ladder so that it cannot change during the analysis or the automated analysis. And I uncheck this so I see where other positions get fixed and unfixed. There we have the same ladder. And then when I think this here is cipher and this is an H, I can have a look at other positions if the H makes sense. And here we have again cipher, so the H makes sense. We have a P, an I, and this here is also a C. And let's have a look. What is the Spanish strip cipher? The name, I think this is an M. Strip cipher is, I don't know, cells, cipher, they're sliding alphabet. I think that the text was, or that these were some sentences that were just put one by one after another, and then you have some spaces where the text doesn't fit. Okay, now let's analyze this again. But as you can see, we can easily decipher a text that has been encrypted using the Spanish strip cipher. I also tested this component to decipher ciphertext from Mystery Twister. Mystery Twister is a web page for crypto riddles. And I think in the future, when we have a new design for Mystery Twister, I will also make a video about Mystery Twister. But on Mystery Twister, you find a lot of crypto riddles. You can solve these. You have to register on the webpage. And then when you solve a riddle, you can submit the solution and then you get points. And the more points you have, the higher you are in a global best list that you can also see on that webpage. And we have some examples of this, or some challenges with the Spanish strip cipher on Mystery Twister. And I could solve the English one and the Spanish one using this component. So when you want to get some points on Mystery Twister and you did not yet register on Mystery Twister, give it a try. Register and try to solve the Spanish strip cipher ciphertext using the Homophonic Substitution Analyzer. Clearly, when you want to analyze a Spanish cipher, then you have to change here in the analyzer this to Spanish and this here also to Spanish. I will link below this video where you can find Mystery Twister, and I think I can also link the text so that you can try the analyzer with these texts. Yeah, and we are now at the end of this video. That's everything I wanted to show you with the Spanish strip cipher. I hope you like this video. If yes, please give a thumbs up. If no, you know what to do, give a thumbs down. Also, it would be really nice if you did not yet subscribe to this channel. If you do so, this really helps me. This really helps to grow this channel and to make Crypto2 more popular. So, thank you very much for watching and see you in the next video.